ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we're here again on the Upper West Side of Manhattan on Central Park West on this lovely January day, Saturday. And I'm here with Kevin Olson, a wonderful pianist. And we understand you're here because you're curious about music and want to hear some live music and want to see what's going on in New York City with us. So without any further ado, we'll jump into this Ravel piece called Habanera. This is Kevin's first time playing this particular piece, and we had very, very little rehearsal, so it's very kind of him, again, to quickly be a sport, come along and learn this music. It's difficult, I think, for pianists to sort of sight-read Ravel or Debussy. It's a lot of unusual chords and very beautiful chords, almost like jazz, so it's kind of nice. One of my favorites.
Excuse me.
Kevin, where are you from, originally?
Knapp, Wisconsin.
And did you live there for many years and then come east, or how did you get to New York City?
I came to study music.
Uh-huh.
At 18.
And you're also doing some piano tuning, yes? I think you work for Steinway.
Yeah.
That's very nice. Is that difficult? Is there a lot of work these days during the COVID thing, or
no.
Not so much? No,
things, no, actually, no.
Things have gotten slow?
Almost none.
Hmm. Well, the next piece is appropriate for that kind of situation. It's called Lush Life.
Oh, yeah.
And the reason why I say that is because we're going to play it sort of in a very slow, kind of a horizontal sound of things that kind of go on forever, it seems. And I guess we sort of feel this pandemic is going on forever. So we're going to, it probably has semi-cheerful lyrics, or it talks about the life of going out partying and going to bars and all this kind of stuff. But we're going to play it sort of like, what's the word? To languish? What was the other word that we liked? Well, anyway, it's going to be sort of like a very ethereal, mysterious kind of sound like this. We'll try to create that kind of a mood, a COVID mood. All set? Okay.
Thank you.
Sort of maybe creates a little bit the mood of some of the blasé feeling that we're in, if that's the correct word. It's hard to find the right word for it, but that's kind of the idea of something that just seems to go on forever. It's important that we get a chance to play music during these times. It's very important. And it's kind of interesting because we are both, I would say, sort of journeyman musicians. You know, we started off little kids studying music. Did you like to practice when you were a kid, Kevin?
Practice
the piano. Did you like that? Did your parents force you to practice the piano when you were a kid, or you were very motivated?
No. No. My mother discovered that I was a chatterbox second day of summer vacation. She was a teacher, and we were both out for the whole summer, and I followed her around the house, talk nonstop. She came up with the piano idea. It was giving me something to do.
To go to the piano, sit down and practice and play the piano all day. And you liked that, yes? You were motivated?
I was. I enjoyed it.
Was she a musician?
Amateur musician, not...
Uh-huh. My parents were musicians, so for me, it was part of the whole family vocabulary, and I didn't really want to practice every day. I wanted to play the violin very much when I was little. There was a little violin up in the closet that I wanted to take down. It belonged to my brother. But anyway, I finally was big enough to play the little violin and began to study. But again, not realizing I had to practice when I wanted to climb trees and play baseball, it was very painful when my friends would follow me home from school and say, "Can Gregory come out and play?" And my mother would say, "No, he has to practice the violin," you know, so that's that. Anyway, someone's drilling a drill outside. So we're going to close the windows a little bit, see if that will help, and we'll think about our next tune. What's our next tune? Do you want to play the... This is New York City, and you're hearing this live.
This can go on for an hour and a half.
This is a live stream. They're doing some drilling, some whatever it is, but I suggest we continue playing in the meantime, because that's what happens in New York. So go ahead. We had a jackhammer with piano and violin today for you. There's no extra cost to a ticket admission for that, but we did have Mark get on the phone and talk downstairs to the doorman to run out to cross the street and ask him to quit with the jackhammer for a few minutes. But you got New York City live today in the year 2021 in January. In the meantime, we'll play another tune for you if I can find the music here. Here we go. I think this is it. Yeah, this is it. Kevin, do you know about this piece? Can you tell the audience a little bit about this Ritratto in Branco e Petto, what this means?
The English translation is Portrait in Black and White, written by Antonio Carlos Jobim and Chico Buarque.
And did you have a chance to meet them at one point?
I met Jobim would come into the Parker Meridian Hotel to listen to a trio, a Brazilian trio. I went there also to hear the same group. So one time I had arranged to meet with my wife, who had a habit of being late. So by the time she got there, she missed the whole first set. I'm at a table with Jobim, having drinks with him. And I said, "Susan, I'd like you to meet Antonio Carlos Jobim." She's just about passed out.
Because he's very well known and very popular.
Oh,
very wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah, that was really fun.
All right.
Very memorable.
And so this is one of the pieces he wrote.
Yeah.
And it's called what? About black and white? What was it?
I don't speak Portuguese, so yeah. I don't know how to say that. But the English translation is Portrait in Black and White.
Portrait in Black and White. Thank you. Here we go. We'll give it a shot.
I don't need it. I'll just do it.
You swing it, sort of.
Mm-hmm.
I hope we did. I hope we did it justice, or at least we got close. And that's something very interesting. That's what's beautiful about the language of music, is that you get to understand people a little bit differently through their food or through their music. So I feel curious about this music. Is it primarily music you would consider from Portugal or
Brazil?
They speak Portuguese, but it's from Brazil.
Oh, it's very...
He's very Latin, sort of, with a... And what about bossa and rumba and all that stuff you were telling me the other day? Something?
Well, this was one of the founding fathers of it.
Well, this was the founding father of which one?
But was Jobim.
And of
bossa nova.
Bossa nova. So this was the composer was the founding... One of the original founding composers of the bossa nova feel, yes?
Yeah.
I see. Interesting. Now, perhaps a little switch of country. We'll go... Something you will recognize, very likely. We won't tell you what it is, but I think you're going to recognize it, and we hope you do. We're going to play it slowly, almost like a classical composition. So we dream of summertime here in January because we hope very soon it'll be warmer and it'll be a sign that we can come outside and play. Come outside, play music and eat some food and ride bikes and just enjoy some kind of an alternative to staying cooped up inside all the time. So we continue to amuse ourselves these days. Kevin's mostly out of work. I'm mostly out of work. But we do what we can musically at home. We practice and we get together maybe once a month and play a little bit, just like today. We're thankful that we are Mark Woodcock's here on Central Park West. And I do some artwork, as you know, to keep me sane. And I play a little bit of music, I guess, to play us out. I think we're pretty much through with the show today, unless there was some questions or things I should mention. I do have my calendar here, my 2021 calendar, which is just came out recently. It's amazing. This year we got it out before the new year started. But now it's January, and the calendar has some nice pictures and things. This is my violin shop. There's some different pictures here. That's Bryant Park, where I spent some time this summer riding my bicycle down to Bryant Park and speaking with nice people that I enjoy spending some time with. And so now we're in the cold weather, no restaurants indoors. We eat outside when we can, and we do the best we can musically. So I guess I'll leave you with a little up-tempo number, and that's again the idea of the violin being able to play jazz and classical music and country western music, etc. So I'll play a little Irish music in the background. Maybe Mark will key up some of the pictures of my calendar and some recent artwork. Also, my pictures came out recently in the Dutch Tree Club 100th membership guide. They used a lot of my artwork. In fact, 11 pieces of my art are in that Dutch Tree Club membership directory, and so I'm kind of happy about that. Maybe my art career will start to blossom a bit with all this free time on my hand. Thank you, Mark Woodcock, for all that you do for us. We really appreciate it. Thank you, Kevin Olson. Thank you, Kevin Olson.
Thank you, Greg.
Appreciate it very much. Give you a high fist pump there, and thanks for your lovely playing today and your suggestions for the music. Appreciate
my
it.
My pleasure.
It goes a long way. So thanks, everybody. Thanks for coming to our show, and I hope you enjoy it.